Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I hope everyone is doing well out in the world during these crazy times with COVID-19 going on and everything. I pray health and success and wealth to any families who have been affected by COVID-19. And my prayers go out to any families and anyone who has been affected. Today's gonna be a video that's a little bit different. I'm going to be discussing how to cope with anxiety, stress, and depression. These are all three things that people don't really like to talk about and don't really think is an issue until it's like something that's very serious in your life. So yeah, I'm gonna talk about those three things and how to cope with it. So I'm gonna give you a couple tips on what I do to deal with that and what you can do yourself to deal with that once it starts coming up in your head. Because if anyone can relate to feeling anxiety or stress or depression, give this video a thumbs up right now so I know that you guys are on the same page. But yeah, guys, during this season of COVID-19, I know that everybody has been going through stressful situations. Some people lost their jobs. Some people, you know, can't afford to pay their rent or pay to get food on the table for their children. So I understand completely the stress that comes along with this whole virus thing. These are some ways that you can deal with that anxiety and stress that you deal with on an everyday basis. So the first thing that I do, the main thing that I do is pray. I have to make that number one on my list. I pray and read my Bible. So whatever you believe in or whatever spirituality you believe in is what you should try to seek after first, because once your spirit is fed, then you could feed everything else. Such as physical, you know, emotional, anything like that. Once your spirit is fed, then everything else just lines up together. So the one thing that I do is pray. I get down on my knees and pray to God, because when I'm going through a stressful situation, I feel sometimes that I'm alone. But then when I think about how God has always had me in the past, I remember that I'm not alone and I start to pray. So that's one of the things that I do is pray, and I read my Bible. And even when I'm reading my Bible, I try to relate it to my life. So whatever I'm reading, I started with Psalms 1 and I just started reading the whole of Psalms. So every scripture that I read, I just kind of relate it to my life, and I'm just like, yes, that's me. God is on my side. God will protect me. God will guide me, and God will assist me with any issue that I'm going through. So when you read your Bible, you want to make sure you relate it to your life as well and follow the instructions that it's saying. So if it's saying God will only bless those who trust in him and follow him and do not sin before his eyes, then you have to do that. You have to follow and do what the Bible says. So you're not going to just read your Bible and just, you know, go about your day how you usually do. You want to make those changes and those steps so that God can bless you and reward you for trusting in him and believing in him and having faith in him. So that is one tip that I have to give, is that, you know, you should pray, read your Bible, get into the word, listen to gospel music if you can. And that's one thing that relieves my stress and anxiety and depression. That's like the top number one thing, I'm telling you. If you don't believe in God, or if you don't believe in, you know, any higher power or whatever you believe in, I believe in God, then I highly suggest that you believe in something, because you taking on this world for yourself is not gonna work. You'll literally kill yourself. That's why a lot of people, you know, commit suicide and all those things, because life is overwhelming. And if you feel like you're alone in it, and if you feel like no one likes you and, you know, you don't have any friends and things like that, then it'll get depressing and you'll just, you know, you'll be like, life doesn't have anything to offer when life is so beautiful at the end of the day. So yeah, that is my first tip. My second tip is to listen to inspirational music and talks, like motivational talks. So that goes back to me listening to gospel. That is one type of inspirational music that I listen to, is gospel music. As soon as I put on gospel music and it fills up my room, it's like another type of mood. And it just makes me feel comfortable. It makes me feel relaxed. It just brightens my day when I play some type of inspirational music. So I play gospel. I also listen to like my favorite artists that are like nice and soothing and just relate to my life, like SZA, Summer Walker, and Jhené Aiko. Like their music is just, especially Jhené Aiko, her music is just so relaxing. So I just like to listen to those type of artists because I know it'll bring me in a better mood. So any type of music or anything that'll bring you in a better mood is really, really good to just relax yourself and de-stress and get rid of that anxiety and thinking about what's the next step in your life. Like, you know, sometimes you just need to just sit back and relax and listen to something inspirational. And another thing is motivational speakers as well. So you can listen to any type of motivational speakers. Just type up motivational speakers for women, motivational speakers for if you want to start a business. You know, there's like millions of things on YouTube that you can search up and just listen to and kind of like get that into your head that, you know, you're not stuck where you are. You can change your situation. You can change how you think, you know. You're not stuck where you are. Like, you can change your mindset and you can change the way you think and elevate to higher things. So definitely listen to motivational speakers on YouTube. So the third tip that I have is to practice breathing exercises. When you find yourself stressed out and just so like at ease, like at, you know, like tense and stuff, just take a step back. Relax, feel your body, feel the muscles on your body, feel, you know, your breath going in and out. This is something called mindfulness meditation. Mindfulness meditation is when you just be in the moment. Like, you forget everything that's going on. You forget if you had the oven on, if you didn't do laundry today. Like, you forget everything and you just be in tune with your breath. Be in tune with your body. Like, just feel the different parts of your body. Feel your feet, feel your hands, feel your arms. And you listen to a mindfulness meditation video on YouTube. You can literally just type up mindfulness meditation or guided meditation. Breathing exercises are really good because it just brings you out of woosah. Like, you can just focus on your breath and breathe in, breathe out. You're breathing in all the stress and anxiety, and you're breathing it out. That's basically it. So another thing that I like to do is just to stay busy. Just not actually like stay busy, but just go out and do something. Go out and do something that you like. Don't just stay in the house. I know we have to stay in the house most of the times because of quarantine and everything, but you know, like, you can go to the park or like go to a special like event or something, ride a bike, get some fresh air, go to the grocery store, go to the pharmacy, you know, just get out and do something. And also do things with friends as well, you know, get a couple of your friends around, go to the park, go to the beach, you know, wherever you can go during this time, just get some fresh air and do something. Like, because once you do something, you're keeping yourself occupied and you're not really thinking about anything that you may have been stressing about for the week or stressing about for the day. You're just in that moment and you're not gonna think about anything that's stressing you out at that moment, I guarantee, if you're keeping yourself busy doing something else. So please, I actually have one more tip that I wanted to say because I always do this, and this is like just having a self-care day for yourself. You know, just relax, have a day for yourself where you just relax and you do all those things that I just told you about. You know, you listen to inspirational music, you just get a face mask. I love face masks, like, they really de-stress you. Yeah, get a face mask, put on a nice face mask, light a candle, just lay on your bed and just soak in that face mask. Get a cold rag and just put it on your head, or a warm rag, whatever you prefer, and just put it on your head and just feel the warmth or the coldness of that rag and just forget about all your stresses, because at the end of the day, it's gonna be there. It's gonna be there. And you're gonna tackle it one day. And you should be working on tackling them. But you don't want it to take a toll on your health and your mental health and your well-being. So you want to make sure that you take care of yourself and practice self-care. If it's doing your hair, doing your nails, things like that, make sure you stay up to date with your self-care as well. And yeah, guys, that's it for my tips. That was about 5 tips for you guys. I hope you guys can relate to what I'm going through, because I know I'm not the only one out there. I really do. If you guys have any other tips that you may suggest for other people, definitely leave it down in the comments section below. Give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed and you're going to practice some of the tips that I gave you. And I'll see you in my next one. You better practice your self-care. Don't be depressed. Don't be stressed. Don't be anxious. God got you, okay? All right, guys. Bye.
Treat me like YG's. Don't get me dirty. Love, love, love on me. Love, love, love on me. She cannot come with. I just gotta dip. Level up with me.